everybody. Stephanie Young here. Today is my special promotional video for Realms of Tokala. And I was going to try to make a song, or try to add vocal to a song, but couldn't figure out how to find the sound fonts that I use for the bard song. It's an instrument called a sister, so. If you're wondering who this little guy is, I created him. He's a Mertani, Mertani. They're like the elf kind of people, nymph-like beings who, they live in treetops. Their spines are curved and very thick. They act like springs, so they can jump really high. And, these are all the, these are some of the animations that he has, the idle and the jump animation. It's just the idle and the jump animation, but I have a running animation I made for him and a spell casting. I think that has this. Yeah, this one is just the idle and the jump. I think he has a spell casting also. Yeah, see, they have the bird-like talon feet, so they can perch on high treetops and stuff. Anyway, guys, sorry I forgot to record earlier. I said a whole lot more about these guys in the past. Now, maybe I'll look for other stuff in have all kinds of stuff. Here's the Project Tokala. There's the Mertani. With some animations. Mertani, you can see it. There's animated fern I made. I made it kind of look like it's blowing in the wind a little bit. I think I had a little bit of issue with the transparency on the UV map that I made. I don't know if I ever made a Project Tokala. I don't know if I made the here we go. There's a stone, random stone. There's a supposed to be a potion here that I made. Just to show you, there's a health potion in a bottle. Kind of made kind of looks weird. I tried to make it look like glass, but it looks like the glass is just red. And can't see liquid in it. But it could be like a bottle filled with red liquid. Put a little leather straps around the top. I guess to give the illusion that you could carry it by the strings. By the way, the reason I make these things here. Health potion. Let's go back to the thing here. See what else we've got. There's a table I made. Oh, there's the Tarl Pulruk. I didn't add all the models I made. That's the male one there. I made a female one too. But, I don't know if I added the female to this compilation here, this collection. There's there's mushroom. I actually made this mushroom into a house. It's just a mushroom, but I added some windows and stuff to it, and didn't add those to this collection either. So this is this is what the mushrooms in the game will look like. They grow in the jungles of the region Bara Mori, B-A-R-A-M-O-R-Y. Just showing you some of these assets that I made when I was still able to make assets for the game. Here's a... Oh, this is a hollowed out log that you find in the forest and stuff in the game. Hollowed out log. Tried to make it kind of dead looking. I think I took some pictures of actual logs in my parents' backyard and added the textures to this model I made. I made a cylinder, then I hollowed out the inside of the cylinder, then I moved stuff around to make it look, have little spikes coming out of the ends of it. It turned out actually pretty good. And also, I made all kinds of assets for this game, but I didn't add them to Sketchfab for whatever reason. Here's a table that I made. Here, a table. I made a log cabin, and I made other stuff. Oh yeah, there's a stone, random stone I made. It's like a jade stone made of jade or something. Stone design one, I had a couple of different stones. I had one that was like brown. I had one that was made of a white marble type thing. I made all the UV texture maps and stuff. Can't remember anything. It's not the stroke damage and stuff, but here we go. Okay, let's look at this stone again. It actually looks pretty good. I'm surprised at how well this turned out. I used to have a knack for making 3D models. Long time ago, and I forgot everything, how to do and everything. Here's the table. I'll show you the table. I think, didn't I already show you the table? They always take a minute to load. This is a table that, in the prototype of the game, one of the first prototypes, table is sitting in the cabin that I created also. I don't know why I don't have any of these things here. I have all kinds of just another 3D noob. I love that. It's an old picture of me from the past. I made other stuff like these are some things. Here's a I made these for Skyrim, but I repurposed them. Like I repurposed this armor to I kind of moved stuff around on it to make it work for. Yeah, I called it kids clothes because I made it as a kids shirt, kids clothes for a. This is my favorite, my donut that I made. I made it as a really good looking chocolate donut. See how shiny it is? It reflects the background. Because I love shameless love for I guess this is a miscellaneous. Yeah, miscellaneous. I also made a 2 3D models of Sentret and a Furret for a Pokemon game. And this one here is the old Furret for the Pokemon game I made. That I was making it for. I didn't make the Pokemon game, I was making it for a Pokemon game. And, there's the updated version of Furret. Somebody helped me out. By the way, here's a loaf of bread. I also wanted to use for the Tokala game. And I'll tell you what the Tokala game is, by the way. It's an allegory like Chronicles of Narnia, Pilgrim's Progress, and Lord of the Rings. But it's more like Chronicles of Narnia, where the Aslan or Jesus character is a fox named Tokis, T-O-K-I-S. I think I also made a pizza. There's a muffin I made right there. Oh, there's the pizza. Pepperoni pizza. Because I'm kind of crazy about pepperoni pizzas. I put little spices on it too. Yeah, I add all this stuff in the Substance Painter program. If I could figure out how to add all these are low poly. Oh yeah, I'll show you the muffin I made. All these food items I wanted to use for Realms of Tokala. Oh, there's the chocolate chip muffin. Chocolate chip muffin. All these, I made a polar bear. I could probably repurpose that for Realms of Tokala. Here's my chocolate chip muffin. Doesn't it look good? I mean, it doesn't look very... The texture, it is low poly. It looks good, it just doesn't look like an actual cake. But, I might even use this repurpose the polar bear. I know I'm repurposing the polar bear. I made this polar bear from scratch. You see, I posed him the same way that Skyrim poses its bears. Cause I made him to replace the ice bears in Skyrim. It's just examples of my work. I'm sorry I couldn't make like a lyric video or anything, a video to show on the YouTube channel for Project Tokala. By the way, it's geared towards young people who will play as a character called the Steward, which is an angelic being. Who, if we get enough people to help us out, The mouth needs a lot of work. I didn't add any textures to the tongue or anything, or to the inside of the mouth at all. It doesn't even have eyeballs. It has fake eyeballs on it. But it actually looked pretty decent in the game Skyrim. There's this little tail. I put little paw pads on it. Aw. Isn't it cute? I love polar bears. They're one of my favorite creatures. I like polar bears. I like bears. I like foxes, obviously. Let's go back to for my stuff. This is kind of showing everything. And here's a armor I made for the Bertani people. See, it has a shiny little helmet there. I was planning on making a also a spell casting. Because these people, they're kind of tribal people, so I made a tribal kind of armor for them. It's kind of rusty. It had like dirt and rust on it. Made the same sequins on here that I made for the you see these sequins, they're throughout the whole armor to the bottom here. Little metal sequins. I'm pretty sure I just probably got a texture online for the actual skirt part. Yeah, I made this to fit on a Mertani person. But if I could find some more people to help us out, it could probably fit on other races. By the way, the steward can be one of any of the races. Oh, it's got the little ear holes. There's the eye. Eye slots there, it just goes over the head. It kind of falls on the head like that. Anyway, the fox god Tokis. By the way, Tokala means fox. It's a Native American name. It means fox. So the Aslan Jesus character is a fox named Tokis, and the steward is one of 12 stewards, most of which either fell from Tokis the creator, or the first steward was much loved by Tokis the creator, and he was but he betrayed Tokis and plunged the whole planet into chaos and just darkness, evil. And he was the cause of wars and plagues and disease, infirmities, everything bad. He recruited some of his fellow stewards to join him. They became his minions. Drolkar, they're like demons, because he's the lord of the demons. He's a demon lord. And the role of the steward, the last one, is to help, because Tokis, the Jesus character, he's very humble and he asks for help ridding the planet of this evil nuisance. I had a lot of like concepts and stuff for armor, so I had the Inferno armor and other stuff. So I'm just clicking. There's the. Yeah, I remember repurposing a lot of these models. I wish I had more of the models I made on here. But I'm sorry, guys. By the way, I'm looking for people of every talent, skill, ability. Artists, 2D and 3D artists, I'm looking for those. I'm looking for people who can help out our developer, I'm in the Unreal Engine. But, there you go. Hope you liked my 3D model. It's nice. Another way, I also need storytellers who can help me create more quests and stuff. And people can brainstorm maybe some new races. We have currently have 6 playable races, and they're not all fully functioning in the game yet. So I don't have models for all of them, or I don't have rigs, animations for most of them. The only ones I think I've only made two. No, I made 3. I made fox people, the Tokala race, because yeah, they're fox people. And also made the Mertani and the Tarl Ulrich people. It's Tarl Ulrich is spelled T-A-R-L. There's an apostrophe and then H-U-L-R-U-K. I think that's how you pronounce it. I mean, I didn't make the race, somebody else did, so. There's the amphibious people, the Tohona, which are the kind of frog people, the Tohona, T-O-H-O-N-A. And there's also the Pale Guardians, which are they're a manufactured race. They have pale, translucent skin. You can see their blue veins underneath. They're like automatons. I wouldn't say soulless, but they were created by this ancient elven race, I think. I think I was going to call them the Eidolons, or somebody mentioned that name, Eidolon. All this is such high resolution pizza. Hope this stuff looks tasty. Yeah, I put the red on the side to look like sauce on the pizza. I didn't add had another character, the female version of this. It looks just like the male, except I made the face more feminine and gave it a semblance of a female breast on it. I made her slimmer. Even though they're the same size and strength, the male and female on Tarl Ulrich people are they kind of make themselves to look masculine and feminine. Cause they weren't supposed to look like this. They were supposed to be dragons. The Tarl, T-A-R-L, the dragon people. They're supposed to be dragons. Let me look at his feet. Let's look at his feet. I'm just seeing if I had the scales on. The toenails on each toe. I think I did. I think I put the toenails on each toe. But, he has scales going down. And about these guys, they have spikes coming out of their joints, the joint areas like the elbows, the shoulders and everything. Because what happened when the dragons were cursed and pressed into a human form, their bones kind of got squashed. Because this isn't their natural form, they are dragons. I haven't added the eyeballs. I wanted to add some eyeballs to these guys in the future. That's one thing I I'm bad at making his eyeballs because I can't make the irises. I made the iris for the Mertani, but he just has slots where the eyeballs are supposed to go. Yeah, I designed it according to how my friend had made a sketch of this race. Haven't really seen heard from him in a while. Yeah, you see both the shoulders are pretty much the same because it's I made it perfectly symmetrical. Yeah, they're not supposed to look like humanoids, but they were cursed into humanoid form. Anyway. Yeah, it made this armor here thicker. Move the legs up and the arms to accommodate the scales underneath to make it fit the Tarahulrug people. Let's look at the cute little donut again. I love this. This is my favorite one. Even though it's the most basic one I've made, it's my favorite. I made it really shiny to look like a Krispy Kreme donut. If any of you are familiar with Krispy Kreme, they make the best donuts. I'm not sponsored by them or anything. I'm not sponsored by anyone. This is currently it's going to be a not-for-profit game project. I'm sorry, guys. It's geared towards young people who play as the steward. It's like the hero, kind of like the heroes in the fable games. Is there like an angel, kind of? Let's look at my polar bear again. I love this guy. Just showing you what I used to be able to do in the past. I used to be pretty good at it. But I still call myself a noob because I was... This is before I had all the horrible strokes, massive stroke series and everything. Took most of my brain's logic and processing and most of my former artistic talent, skills, and abilities. I was thinking, I wish I had more people to help out in the project. Bible study got out kind of late and then got home and spent time with my husband. Pretty much stayed up really late spending time with each other. So I'm really dead tired today, but I'm hoping not. I'm going to get good sleep tonight. I already feel like I want to fall asleep. Anyway, guys, I guess I'll call this promotional video quits now. Love y'all. God bless. Take care. Have a good Friday and a good week.